Oh yeah, you've heard that sound before. You have seen so much going on here this week, and of course it means it has to be Water Cooler Wednesday. Here today, Mr. Kevin Cerrito with I Love Memphis, and of course our very own Todd Demers.
First up, let's talk about the Clint Eastwood movie, American Sniper, getting an awful lot of nods in the movie industry, nominated for Academy Awards already, and it broke a record?
Earned more than $90 million.
Yeah, first weekend out. Anyway, the movie focuses on real-life Iraq war soldier Chris Kyle. Director Michael Moore, though, seems to be not too much of a fan of the movie. Some controversial comments on Twitter. One of them, I'm quoting here, he grew up being told that snipers are cowardly. And boy, his comments are causing some controversy. So, Kevin, were you, as a blogger, you're used to throwing things out there that maybe stir up some stuff, but what was your impression?
Well, I mean, I was shocked to see somebody talk about American Sniper and not talk about the baby, because everything I've seen on social media, oh, the baby, it's a fake baby in the movie or something like that. I haven't seen it yet. So I was shocked about that first. But if you look into it, Michael Moore, uncle or something was shot by a sniper. There's some history to it. But at the same time, like, I don't think you go around calling anybody a coward that's in a position that you would never put yourself in.
Mm-hmm. Good point. A whole class of people. Right. Yeah.
Or to take that one personal experience and try to put it on everything else here. It's like those two particular instances don't seem to match up. Michael Moore is an interesting director. He's done a lot of interesting things. He's brought a lot of things to life.
He's also known for really kind of stirring the pot, to say the least.
And I mean, I've enjoyed some of his previous work, but I certainly don't agree with his statement of taking that personal little instance there and trying to apply it worldwide. Oh, and by the way, the whole situation with the baby. I read that Clint Eastwood, apparently the first baby had a fever, the backup baby didn't show up, and then they just said, get the doll. So that's why.
So it really is apparent that it's a doll? Because I've wondered about that as well. Yeah. I haven't seen
Clint Eastwood just kind of shrugged his shoulders, just moved on.
Mm. All right, we'll move on. This one is getting a lot of attention as well. Parents in England sent a child a bill for $24 because he missed their child's birthday party. The 5-year-old's parents found the bill in their son's backpack. They say they had every intention to going to the party, but realized at the last minute they had double booked. Now the parents of the birthday kid have threatened to take the little boy's parents to small claims court. So Todd Demers, is this too much? Has this gone completely too far, or does it make sense?
Yeah, forgive
parties.
Me. We didn't make Stevie's birthday party last year.
Yeah, I know. Well, your bill is in the box over there. I mean, you know, you were down for three, and you know. You know, most places that we go to when we have a birthday party, they just kind of count the heads at the end of the party and go, here's how much we owe you. They don't, like, charge you all out in advance and in front. This
but
parent must be upset.
Do.
No integrity. I can't believe this parent would do something like that. That's nuts.
It's like, it's an unwritten rule of life that you know, you just pay for it. That's
you,
just what
you
happens.
Just pay for it, and but chances are good. You know, if you get 10 people that you think are coming, there's going to be a couple that are going to miss.
Have those birthday parties, though, become that expensive for those who
don't
have kids?
It was only $24.
I know. That was per person, though.
Right, right. Yeah, but I mean, if you're going to have that party, you got to be willing to pay that money. I'm just afraid, like, if I had a kid, I wouldn't even, like, let the kid go play at this person's house.
I wouldn't either.
They probably have, like, a pay toilet, or they're sending you half of their MLGW bill because...
I have some extra children at home. If you'd like to take one to a party, you just let me know. I'll be sure to share.
What about if you invite people and they bring siblings? I'm just saying, there's another flip side of that without asking. That happens.
Should they be charged?
I know that's happened to you. I mean, sometimes that gets kind of out of control. Is that do you just swallow it?
What do you think?
I mean, I
should say plus one on the invite, right? Like everything else.
Not at $200 a pop to go jump on some trampolines. No.
That is true. That's a difficult one, though, Mary Beth.
We will keep it moving, you guys. What else?
All right. Well, a problem with some of the contestants in the Miss Universe pageant. Miss Lebanon is distancing herself from an Instagram photo of her and Miss Israel. Both women were in Miami to compete in the contest. And in a Facebook post, Miss Lebanon accused Miss Israel of jumping into the photo, basically doing a photo bomb on her selfie. Miss Israel said she was saddened by the negative reaction to the pictures. Tensions remain high between Israel and some other Arab countries, of course, and apparently in Lebanon it's very frowned upon to interact with people from Israel. So the organization is really trying to downplay this. I'm saying somebody is not going to get Miss Congeniality. That's all I know at this point. I mean,
Imagine how much trouble she'd be in if she was using a selfie stick to do it.
But she'd beat her with it.
I want to see it become one of the questions at the pageant, asking whether it's to them or to somebody else, but to bring this issue to light. I think it's outrageous. They just took a picture together, and it's war. Say, oh, we love war so much that we don't want any peace between anyone involved in this.
Would
I think
that be
it's
a good way for the pageant to handle it? Maybe instead of trying to run away from
whether
it?
Whether asking them or other contestants in the pageant about it when you get to the question and answer portion.
That's
so, Todd, what does it say?
I think the folks at the pageant and all the contestants are probably going, eh. It's probably everybody back at home that are having a problem with all of that. But that's interesting. I hate to see that. You'd like to think that these people get along even though they are going to be, up against one another.
Don't send somebody there if you don't want them interacting with somebody that's
going to happen.
That's a good point. Yeah. That's a good point. Maybe the Lebanese Pageant Association needs to rethink.
Somebody maybe withdraw.
I'm putting that in the questionnaire because it certainly does not represent the country well.
Guys, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
All right.